Hi Virgo, welcome to my channel. I am an intuitive tarot card reader and this will be your intuitive three card spread for the upcoming week. If you like this reading, please feel free to leave behind a like or subscribe so I know that you enjoy this weekly content and would like to see more of it. If you were after a private reading, all the information you require is listed below in the description box, my email list of prices and services. Otherwise, thank you so much for being here, Virgo. Let's have a look and see what's coming up for those born under the sign of a Virgo. Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. What's coming up for Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus for the upcoming week? The messages Virgo needs to know. Okay, this one's sort of hanging out. And what do we have here? Okay, death. An ending is on the precipice. Okay, an ending might be on the horizon with the death card followed by the Two of Swords. And then the last card is the Four of Cups. Okay, the death card. For those that are dealing with a Scorpio, I feel like this person is coming in quite strongly here. This person is reflecting. I feel like they might be in a period where they're reflecting. I feel like I want to focus more on you, Virgo. So it could be that you might feel like you're in a period of reflection. But I just mean to say that this, of course, could be a Scorpio coming through quite strongly for you in the upcoming week. You may receive some sort of signal, some sort of sign that this person is your twin flame because she can see her reflection in the mirror here, her twin, her other half, her equal, okay? This is quite powerful. But back to the death card, as much as it can symbolize loss, grief, and endings, it can also symbolize rebirth. So in one aspect, there could be an ending or a parting of ways because you do have the Two of Swords, which shows a block. The Two of Swords is a barrier. It's a fork in the road. Some of you will choose the option to leave an unhealthy situation or leave behind a situation that doesn't serve you purpose. Sometimes endings need to happen, Virgo, because only when we close certain chapters of our lives off, only then can we usher in the new, only then can we do more self-exploration or invite different people, places, circumstances into our lives, because without that cyclical nature, without those endings, we never have new beginnings. There'll be no chance for rebirth. So without this ending, I don't feel like you can invite new things into your life. So some of you will be stepping away from a certain situation with the death card here. I feel like it's quite an extravagant ending. You can see that the bird, it's quite a dramatic ending. The bird is looks like it's calling out. You know, it's got what looks like flames. It looks like the sun here as well. So I'm not sure if some of you are dealing with a fire sign that has sun fire placement somewhere in their chart here. But I feel as though it's a dramatic end that's occurring for you this week, Virgo. And I feel like the flames and the bird is calling out and it's transformational, okay? It's also transformation and new beginnings that will come to you in the upcoming week. And this, of course, could be in regards to romance, you know, emotional connections, love, possibly even work opportunities. But I do see a dramatic ending happening for some of you, okay? It's quite elaborate way. So you're definitely making some sort of exit here, Virgo. You'll definitely make it known. So say, for example, if you're leaving a relationship, I feel like the way you're going to end it is really dramatic. You know, there could be a dramatic fight or it could be a little bit outrageous even, a little bit scandalous here with the death card, because I feel like in this, it's very bright and it's very well known. So whatever ending that's happening here for you, in whichever regard, I feel like people will know about it, Virgo. People will see it. It'll be available to other people for some reason here. It could also point to the past. Some of you might have someone from your past coming back in, okay? The death card brings people, places, opportunities that have crossed paths with us once more, once before here, Virgo, and will cross paths with us once again. So an opportunity from the past may come knocking. And of course, some of you might need time to think about it, dwell on it, meditate on it. Whilst for others with the Two of Swords, I see that you're absolutely going to say no, you aren't having a bar of it. And I'm not sure if it's because you ended things very outrageously with this person before, or say, for example, if this is a past employer, I feel for instance, for some of you, I feel you left or you quit or you resigned in a very dramatic way or at a dramatic time at the company. There's a bit of drama connected with some sort of ending or something with your past here, okay? I don't want to read too much into it, but I think that's what the death card could be for some of you. It is a highly metaphysical and or spiritual card as well for a lot of you, so there could be an emphasis on this in the upcoming week. The Two of Swords is here, so there's a fork in the road. There's a decision that will need to be made. It could be revolving an air sign, a Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius here. If you are dealing with an air sign, or if you are finding communication is a little bit off, you do have the swords. Someone has their swords up, so someone's feeling overly defensive, or someone's feeling blocked off. So someone might, you might feel you're not connecting with someone as much as you'd like. And you normally need that clarification and validation. You are ruled by Mercury, Virgo. So much like Gemini, you both seek solace, and you both thrive when you receive direction and results and something where your mind can feed off. And I think a lack of this may leave you somewhat perplexed, because the Two of Swords is you feeling you don't know which direction to take. You don't know which person to choose or which option to go with. So it's a little bit of indecisive energy around you. Maybe you need to weigh up the pros and cons. I see you weighing something up. And for others, I'm not sure if it's the past or a twin flame or learning something new here. The Four of Cups is illumination and enlightenment. So for some of you, you may be encountering this in the upcoming week here. You do have that crescent moon. I do feel it's in regards to love, because you can see that love hangs... And you know, that first card, the death card, was sort of hanging. So it could be the fact that someone is left hanging, or you leave someone hanging here. Because I feel like these swords are very close to the heart. So someone's cutting someone off, okay? You're cutting someone off, or they're cutting you off, okay? I feel like it could be in a very brutal or outrageous or unexpected way. Again, that dramatic cut off or a dramatic end comes to mind here. So it could be for love, and it could be for some of you. For others, it's not necessarily cutting your ties with someone, although it could be. It could also point to that you don't want to talk about love, or you don't want to explore love, or something like this with the Two of Swords. Very close to the heart here. And you also have that crescent moon with a dark sky. So you know, whether this is a waning moon or a waxing moon is hard to say, but the crescent moon can symbolize it's either a build-up or a breakdown happening here. And it's definitely in evolving your emotions here, Virgo. So you might feel that you're quite emotional because of this Two of Swords. Now, you do have the Four of Cups, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio energy with the Four of Cups here. For those that are dealing with a water sign, I feel as though you're going to be learning a lot about this person, Virgo, possibly receiving some sort of metaphysical sign, supernatural sign, that the two of you are meant to be in each other's paths, that the two of you right now are mirroring each other, so you're on the same frequency, and this person is for you. It's really like certifying a twin flame here, so this is quite powerful. It won't be for all of you, Virgos, but in the upcoming week, it is for a lot of you. It also points to self-reflection here. You know, and she dawdles in it. She can see her reflection. The mermaid can see her reflection, and she dawdles in there. So I'm not sure if you're tweaking something about yourself, transforming something about yourself. Looks could be internally. It could be in regards to your emotions. It could be thinking about your emotions. Maybe seeing yourself through different eyes. Maybe seeing yourself differently here with the Four of Cups. It's you deep in thought. Possibly with a water sign here, or a water sign that's... I almost feel like this water sign is daydreaming about you. They're thinking about you a lot. They're considering some really serious things for a lot of you Virgos dealing with a water sign. This person is considering some really, really serious things with you. But you can see the water is void of these lilies, what look like lilies or lotus flowers that the fairies are carrying away. So maybe you're still yet to learn, or you have already learned and you're dwelling on what was once there. I feel like the fairies are taking them away, not bringing them back. It's hard to say if they're actually taking them away or bringing them back, actually, because you can see this one looks like she's sort of going this way, and that one does too, but these ones, I mean, it's hard to say whether you're learning or whether you have already learned something about this person, but it can point to changes here. So new information will come to you in a very powerful way, Virgo, and you'll have a lot, you'll need to think about this quite extensively in the upcoming week. I will leave it at that though, Virgo. I hope this reading has been insightful. It's quite interesting for you in the upcoming week. I hope it's been enjoyable. Don't forget, if you would like to continue to see your weekly readings, please leave behind a like Again, you're more than welcome to join my YouTube family. I'm always looking to expand it, so you're more than welcome to do that. Have a fantastic week ahead. Look after yourself. I'm sending you all my love, and if you were after a private reading, my details are listed below in the description box. Otherwise, all the best and bye for now.